So it's 8:10. Jimmy's just showing up for work. So it's Jimmy left about 8:10, and it's about 8:12 now. He's backing out.
In the weeks before being shot by a masked gunman, Ohika Castle owner Gary Melius was embroiled in a bitter legal dispute with a business partner.
There he goes.
Thanks for telling us about Miami shot 61% for the game, 23 points for Dwayne Wade. Carmelo Anthony scored 29. Fails to finish with just two. Knicks have dropped four in a row. They're a season worst, 16 games under 500, and host the Warriors at the Garden tonight. Meanwhile, the Nets bounce back from their 44-point loss to Portland on a 112-89 route to the Nuggets in Denver. Brooklyn held the Nuggets to 8 first quarter points. Hockey, a clean sweep for the locals, and a return for the Olympic break. The Rangers can't count the loss and shut out with 12 seconds to go, and had to hold on for dear life. The Garden. Hey, what's left?
So there's Jimmy's truck. It's 8:25. He hasn't been to work really yet. Back there, but I can't see him because of the reflection, really.
Texas. Libris Royal Green Appliance Center on East Coast Road in White Plains, and GE can help. Libris Royal Green offers the complete line of GE appliances, always at the best possible prices. Choose from GE Profile, GE Cafe, or GE Monogram brand appliances that complement any taste and budget. As an added bonus, select GE appliances offer rebates up to $3,298. That's right, up to $3,298. Let Libris Royal Green and GE make your kitchen the most functional and beautiful room in your home. Come explore the possibilities at Libris Royal Green Appliance Center and enjoy the full GE appliance experience in their newly renovated state-of-the-art showroom. As you discover the quality and versatility of GE Cafe, Monogram appliances, let the most exceptional sales staff in the tri-state area answer all of your questions. Libris Royal Green and GE, when you want more than just a good price. Libris Royal Green Appliance Center.
I can't see who that is in the orange coat, but we'll get him later. And that's Jimmy in the beige coat. All right, so it's 8:36, and the boys are still there. Just to be clear, that's Jimmy's truck over there, and they're still hanging out, having coffee. I guess I'm just leaving the radio on to show you what time it is, but it's 8:37, and basically Jimmy is yet to work. Coat through this window here. Looks like he's taking off. I'm going outside. Hopefully this guy in the Mercedes I'm shooting through will move his car. Maybe he's just having a cigarette. Yeah, he's having a cigarette. See from all the cars, it's really cold. It's,
Wilbur Sondland has been walked out of the 71st Police Precinct on Thursday night, facing a list of serious charges: attempted murder, assault with a deadly weapon, and criminal possession of a weapon. Sources tell CBS 2 Robinson showed no remorse, telling officers, "I hate expletive cops."
this after Wednesday evening shootout in Crown Heights with two rookie NYPD officers during a stepped-up enforcement of the problem-plagued B-46 bus route.
26-year-old Officer James Lee was wounded in both legs and Robinson's being held without bail. In Westchester, the Terry Kennedy case now is in the hands of the jury in White Plains. As we hear from WCBS reporter Irene Cornell.
Jury deliberations turned first to the testimony of Dr. David Benjamin, a pharmacologist who testified that he believes when Terry Kennedy first felt the effects of the sleeping pills she took by mistake, it came on very suddenly, leaving her in a state of amnesia and sleep driving, unable to make the judgment that she needed.
Calm. Literally. Choose New Jersey. Seriously, what are you waiting for?
Choose Stratton for snow so great it's guaranteed. For big savings on big mountain skiing or riding, visit strattondeals.com or call 1-800-STRATTON. WCBS News Time 918. With traffic and weather together on the 8th as we head to the traffic center first, here's Tom O'Hanlon.
All right, Paul, well, what a day everybody had in Westchester so far this morning. And the cross county is busy eastbound New Rochelle Road into the Hutchinson River Parkway. Part of what's going on is a lot of people heard about that huge accident earlier this morning on 95 and decided to jump on the Hutch. So it's still busy even though the accident on 95 is gone. Northbound Hutch, you're busy as you're approaching the cross county. Now on 95 in Connecticut, northbound, you're busy at 2 up to 4 and slowing down on the over 25. You're riding along the Long Island, the LIE eastbound at exit 48, an accident in the right lane is backed up to the northern. Morning traffic all around Long Island, but no major problems otherwise. In Queens, though, a disabled vehicle in the right lane, and that is on the van light going northbound at Main Street. So as of now, you have a lane blocked, and all the traffic is backed up to around Rockaway Boulevard.
All right, so it's about 9:20. They've been there about 1 hour so far. And I'm guessing that's Phil Rossetti. Can't see the guy to the right. He must have gotten there on his own. I don't see another school district vehicle here, so I'm not clear how he got here.
We've already set some record low temperatures for the morning in Bridgeport, Islip, Kennedy, as well as LaGuardia, but we might not be able to make it up above 20 degrees this afternoon. And keep in mind, the normal high is 44. Temperatures tonight will drop down to about 10 to 15 in the city, 0 to 10 in the suburbs. Mostly cloudy with a chance of a flurry or two late tomorrow. That's it for tomorrow, 30 to 35, not a bad day. It actually gets a little bit milder. Sunday cloudy with some wet snow or mixed precip developing, especially late day, 32 to 37. So we're above freezing on Sunday.
Looks like Jimmy had to go to the bathroom.
And developing later in the day, so it doesn't look too bad on Sunday. The problem is Sunday night and Monday. Most indications point towards the storm either coming in two pieces or one, but that doesn't matter at this point. It looks like it would turn into all snow, cold after that. Snow heavy at times through the day on Monday, 28 to 32. The difference would be Monday night. If it's just one storm, it's out of here by Monday night. If it's two systems, then it lingers on through Monday night into Tuesday morning. Obviously, that would mean some very heavy snowfall amounts. Tuesday, mostly sunny weather returns during the day, 25 to 30. Still can't warm up. 12 now in the city, wind chill zero. I'm Craig Allen in the WCBS Weather Center.
All right, and Craig has his eye on the storm, and you want to check with us this afternoon here at WCBS Weather and right through the weekend. You want to get down to business at our first WCBS Small Business Breakfast of 2014. It's a brainstorming road show that stops on March 27th in Stamford, where we always sell out. You'll want to hear about new ways of doing business and new ideas for growth through marketing, technology, and social media, plus the networking alone is worth coming for. Sponsored in part by Strategic Funding Source, financing the future of small business. To find out more about our breakfast and to lock in your seat, you can head to cbsnewyork.com/small business.
Bring home a luxurious sofa, sectional chair, or recliner upholstered in beautiful leather during the Stigley Leather Sale. You'll save up to $1,000 on already reduced sale prices on the finest names in furniture, all known for timeless design and impeccable craftsmanship. And qualified buyers will enjoy 12 months of no-interest financing, so save up to $1,000 store-wide.
So they did a little over an hour.
Going on now,
it's 9:22. They're in their truck now.
West 25th Street, Manhattan, at Route 4 West, Paramus, New Jersey. Follow Stigley on Twitter and Facebook. WCBS News Time 922.
there's the... Okay, so that's the other guy.
Valentine's Day, after wriggling out of his harness and bolting into the Massapequa Preserve. Harry Donovan in North Massapequa told Newsday it was horrible, like losing a child. The search failed to spot the pooch on Sunday, but then yesterday, the Oyster Bay Town Shelter called to say they had Cody, caught in a trap set up by a shelter and lured in by Jacob, they say. WCBS News Time, 9:23.
All those meds. I'm Pat Farnak with the WCBS Health and Well-Being Report, sponsored by the Valley Hospital in Ridgewood, New Jersey. In America, many people are taking a lot of prescription drugs every day. But Dr. Eric Topol, who wrote The Creative Destruction of Medicine, says, disturbingly, with meds, it isn't one size fits all.
Over 100 commonly used medications have a genomic known DNA interaction, but we don't test for that interaction. In other countries, like Asia, you can't get certain drugs without a genotype done first. But in this country, oh well, if they have a horrible side effect, we'll just have to deal with it when it comes up. The average person over 65 is taking at least 5 to 7 medications. They have interactions not only with their own DNA, but also across the different medications, and we have to do far better than we are doing right now.
Topol says one day soon, that's where a smartphone will come in. The entire interview at
CBS.com/Health and Well-Being. I'm going to try to follow them if I can.
Their hearts beat for you. They are the heart specialists of Valley Medical Group, Northern New Jersey's finest physicians with unsurpassed experience. Strength you can call on anytime. Backed by the Valley Hospital in Ridgewood, New Jersey, ranked number one in New Jersey for cardiac services by HealthBrains for 2013. The heart specialists of Valley Medical Group, they put their hearts into caring for yours. Go to valleymedicalgroup.com or call 1-800-637-1136. WCBS News Time, 9:25, just ahead of the opening bell. Time for business news here on WCBS with...
Got him over here.
...Wall Street Journal. Apple, a $2 billion patent infringement claim against Apple has been thrown out of a German court. IPCOM, a patent-holding firm, says Apple infringed on some of its technology patents tied to technology with the iPhone, but judged throughout that case, as well as a suit against HTC. Wall Street, as you mentioned, getting ready to get started in a few minutes. Stocks should be mostly flat at the open. We still have reports on pending home sales and consumer sentiment due up at 10 a.m. Citigroup has cut its fourth quarter and full year estimates for 2013 after finding fraud with its unit in Mexico in terms of its dealings with an oil services company in that country. Citi is expected to take a $360 million pre-tax charge because of the incident. Mattel has agreed to buy the maker of Mega Bloks, Canada's Mega Brands, for $460 million. Mattel just concluded a poor holiday season and looking to expand its offerings in arts and crafts. And much like the price of movie tickets, the price of ads on Sunday's Oscars telecast are on the rise. A 30-second spot for the broadcast, but 10% bump from last year, up to $1.8 million. But of course, buying a spot on the Oscars is still a great deal compared with getting one during the Super Bowl broadcast. The price, you may remember, $4 million for the Super Bowl this year at the Meadowlands. I'm Dan Loney at the Wall Street Journal for WCBS News Radio 880.
I sit on the bank of the Hudson River, looking across at New York City. On sunny days, I shine. When it snows, I get very, very cold. I've never missed a day of work. I can honestly say that I carry the weight of the economy on my back. I am 1 mile of CSX railroad track. There is one more mountain more than one. We're all here to keep things moving forward. CSX, how tomorrow moves.
Your season for big savings is deer season. Choose 0% financing for 60 months or get big cash off. Select new John Deere tractors from our one family to our powerful 6M and 6R series. These offers won't last long, so hurry in today. Offer in April 3.4 for blue print on John Deere financial installment plan. Some restrictions apply. It'll be there. Nothing says John Deere like LaCorte equipment. Visit us in Calverton or find us at LaCorteEquipment.com and MyJohnDeereDealer.com.
WCBS News Time, 9:27. Traffic and weather together in just a moment, but the University of Connecticut says it plans to fire a professor and a former dean. The dean, they say, for not taking stronger action after learning the professor had been accused of sexually abusing children. Also in news, President Obama and Vice President Biden trying to bring attention to the First Lady's Let's Move campaign. They take the
Jimmy. It's getting close to 9:30. He's driving on Hamilton. The two guys on this trip.
The First Lady has asked people nationwide to use social media to show how they move. Moving or lack thereof, traffic and weather together on the 8th here at WCBS at 9:28. Let's head over to the traffic center and get the update from Tom O'Hanlon.
All right, Paul, well, we are sluggish at the George Washington Bridge. Coming in, you still have those delays. Better than it was for the no party yet, that's for sure. He's down 25-minute drive between the express lanes and the upper tolls. It's about 15 to 20 now at the lower. Lincoln still about a half hour into the city, 20 at the inbound to Holland. And the LIE on the eastbound side of Long Island, by the way, eastbound exit 48 at the 49. You're really getting slammed there. An exit in the right lane. Everybody stop for around Stephen Way to the expressway. Some of the other things.
I'm guessing he's going to go to City Hall.
Down the west side highway. Looks like we're in better shape than we were. It's still sluggish going southbound. It's typical for a weekday morning, but you're still moving. And looks like up and down the D and just some on and off of the ramps. Now, some of the other things, Harlem River Drive southbound, 5th Avenue down into FDR, it is stop and go. And we are sponsored by Delta Vacations. Love is in the air with Delta Vacations. Each week of February, celebrate love and enter to win a vacation package to Mexico or the Caribbean. Visit deltavacations.com/love for details. Offer subject to change without notice. Other restrictions may apply. Now here's Chief Meteorologist Craig Allen in the WCBS Weather Center.
Only about 20 for a high today, then tonight 10 to 15 city, 0 to 10 in the suburbs. Tomorrow clouds move in, but it still gets a little milder, 30 to 35, could be a flurry late. Sunday cloudy, some wet snow or mixed precip developing, not much, should be late.
So he's dropping off Phil.
30s. However, Monday, actually Sunday night into Monday, that changes to all snow, and the potential for heavy snow does exist right through the day on Monday. Right now, 12 degrees in the city, the wind chill is zero. I'm Craig Allen in the WCBS Weather Center.
Hey, man. Hey, man.
Hey, man.
The opening bell, live from the New York Stock Exchange.
Will stocks continue their run? There is hope that they will wrap up a winning week on a high note, but we'll see. Stay tuned.
Opening bell report is next.
New York's Mega Millions jackpot is now over $215 million.
WCBS News Time, 9:30.
News, traffic, and weather for New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut. We are News Radio, WCBS 880. Good morning, Friday, February 28th. I'm Paul Bernays.
Good morning, I'm Pat Carroll. Coming up this half hour of the WCBS opening bell report.
Two EU countries have frozen the bank accounts of the Ukraine's former president.
The economy grew much more slowly in the fourth quarter than expected.
A major Bitcoin exchange filed for bankruptcy in Tokyo.
Protesters and rioters clashed outside the finance ministry in Greece.
Evangelical Christian leaders helped market a Bible movie opening today.
And sports, why tickets to tonight's Knicks game are so expensive.
WCBS News Time, 9:31.
Now, more than ever, it matters where you get your business news. It's the opening bell report on WCBS.
And a minute into the trading day, we're waiting for the numbers to show on the screen. Here they go. The Dow up about 5, NASDAQ up 2.5, and S&P up about a half.
Opening on the upside today. We'll see how it goes on this Friday. Things could be better for Viktor Yanukovych. He can't get the money out of banks in Austria and in Switzerland. Both countries have frozen his accounts and those of his son, as well as 16 others linked to the former Ukrainian government. Austria's foreign ministry spokesman says the move is meant to ensure that no money is withdrawn from the accounts pending an EU-wide decision on whether the former Ukraine president and his closest associates should be put under financial sanctions.
The economy in the U.S. is slogging along. It grew significantly more slowly than first thought in the October to December period. The Commerce Department says the 2.4% annual growth reflected a slowdown in consumer spending. The severe winter weather is expected to slow growth further in the current quarter, but economists believe growth will rebound.
Dow's up 8 points. WCBS News Time, 9:32. A massive loss of virtual currency forces a major exchange out of business. CBS News senior business analyst Jill Schlesinger with more on this.
Mt. Gox, which was one of the marketplaces where people could buy or sell bitcoins, has declared bankruptcy at a Tokyo district court. This is really a fall from grace. Mt. Gox used to claim that it handled about 80% of all global dollar trades for Bitcoin. So the fact that it actually has now declared bankruptcy calls into question.
All right, so now it's 9:35.
I think that Jimmy's
at City Hall, but he's sitting in his truck.
What this means going forward.
Its chief executive says 850,000 bitcoins worth about $425 million based on recent prices are unaccounted for.
Demonstrators scuffled with riot police outside
the finance. I'll pause for now, but now he's here.
Greece today, the protest.